law of the universe. Yes, there are certain laws in which universe operates. There are certain laws which universe accepts and abide. Do you want to know those certain laws that can help you to gain health, wealth and abundance? A reporter asked Einstein once, which is the most important question in this world? You know what Einstein replied? Einstein said, do you want a happy, peaceful and loving world? Or do you want forbidding, scarce and empty world? The same question I want to ask you. I'm sure your answer would be happy, loving, peaceful world. Hi, I'm Ashish Juneja, a peak performance coach. I help entrepreneurs and corporate professionals to double their results in any aspect of their life. Coming back to the question, the 12 universal laws. Let's talk about and dive in. Number one law, law of oneness. The law of oneness talks about that there is one supreme universe and we all are part of fragmented soul of that. If you talk about the Big Bang theory also, the Big Bang theory itself states there was a Big Bang through which the whole universe came in being. So, taking that law into action, we all are fragmented part of the universe. So we all are interconnected. Now how to use this law in your favor? When you know the trees are connected to you, when you know that other people are connected to you. So whatever you think, whatever you give is actually you are giving to whom? You are giving to yourself. So keeping just this law in your mind, oneness, when you are one with the universe, or you are the part of the total universe, I hope you will do all good right things, because all those right things you are not doing to anybody else, you are doing it to yourself only. Now, second part, law of energy. Everything is energy and energy is everything. Yes, we talk about your thoughts. Your thoughts also have some kind of energy. Your thoughts are electric. Your thoughts have energy in motion. So whatever you think is creating some kind of effect in this universe. So think your thoughts wisely. Now how to use this thought? When you know everything is energy and energy is everything, the best way is consume your energy in a way that is not distorted, not affected that much by negativity and external influences. When you know everything is energy, pump up that energy. How do you enhance your energy when everything is energy? Keep in the spirit of the people. Go along with the people who are full of energy, who are vibrant, who are joyful. That is how you keep up your energy. And because everything is energy, you are part of the energy, everything comes back. Law of action. Law of action. Also in the physics, as it is being said, every action has equal and opposite reaction. So whatever you do, an act of karma or just an act will give you some kind of reaction. So law of action states that whatever you do in this world, any karma, any act of yours will bring back something in your life. If you do good deeds, if you do good karma, good things will come in your life. So act wisely. Use this law in your favor, not against you. Law of correspondence. The fourth law, law of correspondence. Law of correspondence states that whatever goes inside comes outside. Even Jesus said that whosoever possess something, whosoever possess the happiness, wealth, will get it more. And someone who is deprived of that, or someone who is having less of that, more will be taken from it. So if you have more of health, wealth, abundance, more will fall back to you. So start increasing your health. Start improving your abundance mindset. More will be given back to you. So correspond with your inner self. You need to think what's going on between your ears. Something that's going on between your ears is your intuition, your inner voice, your core talking to you. Instead of asking people, whether should I take this job, whether should I resign from this job, whether should I take up this assignment, take the guidance from your inner voice. It will give you the right guidance, because inner voice knows your perspective. No other person knows your perspective. So, what's there inside? Using this law of correspondence, bring good and good things inside, so that in the external world or external reality, you get good things. Coming back to the next law, fifth, law of cause and effect. There is a cause, there is an effect. You go and start beating somebody, what you will have? The effect of that will be that person either will beat you or will shout at you. So, when you know this law, when you know universe operates under this law, choose your causes wisely. When you know that there is an effect of certain act done by you, you may be changing your course of action. Just simply by changing your course of action, your cause, when you know that when you talk bad to your colleague, when you talk ill or in a manner that's not positive, you know that's going to come back. There is an effect, there is a repercussion. Choose your words, choose your tone, choose your body language wisely. Now, law of attraction. Very, very, very important. Law of attraction. Like attracts like. Your thoughts, feelings, emotions attract. Your thoughts are electric and your feelings are magnetic. So, if you are thinking good, you will attract good in your life. If you are thinking bad, you will attract bad in your life. Use this law in your favor. If you want to attract a particular job, think about that. If you want to attract a particular amount of money, think about that. Write it on a piece of paper. Start visualizing it. Start looking at it. It's going to manifest in your life. Manifestation is a process of just bringing that thing so real in your subconscious that your body and mind is unable to distinguish whether it's going to happen or is actually happened. The moment your subconscious believes and your body believes, it has already happened. Same, a different kind of rewiring happens in your brain. And the wiring or rewiring your brain affects the real results. Law of compensation. Word is a boomerang. You send something, it comes back. You send something, it comes back. So, think wisely what you are sending to this universe, because that's going to come back. Now, law of perpetual transmutation of energy. Energy can neither be destroyed nor be created. It only changed form, or it only changed shape from one form to the another. When you are feeling energetic, when you are feeling lively, when you are feeling vibrant, act. Do not wait. because that is the energy trying to transmute. Transmutation has to happen. The change of energy has to happen. If you think, oh, right now I'm feeling energetic, I'll do this work. Okay, let me wait till the evening. Let me wait till tomorrow because I'm very energetic. I'll do it anyway. Believe me, by evening, your mood, your thoughts might affect it, might change. Energy that was vibrant, energy that was enthusiastic, energy that was lively. Maybe by the end of the day, you might feel lethargic and you feel bad that you didn't act on. So act on it. Law of relativity. 90% of the wealth is being owned by just the 4% of the population in this world. Nature understands that things cannot be equal. Things and resources in this universe will vary. There will be a variation. There will be something, a kind of care. Nature will keep giving you lows and highs just to strengthen you up. The low phases in your life, those are the relative. You go to any religious institution, outside it, you may find people who are hungry, who are deprived of money. Wow. Things are relative. 4% of the population is uber rich. Those are making billions of dollars. And 96% of the population is one end. So there is a relativity. Universe wants you to be a giraffe. And hence, increase the volume and the length of your neck so that you eat when scarcity comes up. So more and more challenges comes in. More and more challenges that come in your life, those are to enhance you, uplift you. Law of polarity. When you talk about law of polarity, things are complementary. You have day and you have night. You have evenings and you have mornings. So, certain few things are polar that will go hand in hand. You will find people who are rich, you will find people who are poor. So, in your, how to use this law in your life? 60,000 thoughts in a day you possess. You think 5% thoughts or 55,000 thoughts? Polarity. 55 bad thoughts, 55,000 bad thoughts, 6,000 good thoughts. See more of good part. You focus more and more of good thoughts so that those expand. Those expand and slowly, slowly you become more and more of good thoughts. Now, law of rhythm, the 11th law, the law of rhythm. In the universe, rhythm is everything. You find seasons, you find cycles, you find periods. So there are cycles, there are weathers, there are the times. In the Indian scripture, Bhagavad Gita, it's already written. In the times of good, do not be overjoyful. And at the time, in the time of bad, don't get so much depressed. Because anyway, remember one word, even that shall pass too. So when you are finding something tough, when you are finding something that's not relevant in your life, see that it's a rhythm. It's a rhythm. Even that shall pass too. That's going to go over. Gender. Law of gender. Universe also follows the law of gender. What's the law of gender? Universe actually do not think in the form of gender. It's the duality, that's the yin and the yang. The male energy and the female energy. There is a balance. In the universe, there is a balance of energies. Now, you as a creator of your own life, you need to balance your energies, your yin and yang, your male energies and your female energies, your soft energies or soft part of yours and the hard part of yours. Try to balance that. Now, utilizing these 12 laws of nature, I expect that you should be utilizing certain laws. Choose or follow few of the laws or all of the laws and let me know how did you like it. And if you like this video, comment, share, like and subscribe. It's me, Ashish, signing off.